Obviously, research regarding technological unemployment is as vital today as further refinement or production of labor-saving and comfort-giving devices. Among all the marvels of modern invention, that with which I am most concerned is, of course, air transportation. Flying is perhaps the most dramatic of recent scientific attainments. In the brief span of 30-odd years, the world has seen an inventor's dream, first materialized by the Wright brothers at Kitty Hawk, become an everyday actuality. Perhaps I'm prejudiced, but to me it seems that no other phase of modern progress contrives to maintain such a brimming measure of romance and beauty coupled with utility as does aviation. Within itself, this industry embraces many of those scientific accomplishments which yesterday seemed fantastic impossibilities. The pilot, winging his way above the earth at 200 miles an hour, talks by radio telephone to ground stations or to other planes in the air. In thick weather, he is guided by radio beam and receives detailed reports of conditions ahead, gleaned through special instruments and new methods of meteorological calculations. Engines, the reliability of which, measured by yardsticks of the past, is all but unbelievable. I myself still fly a Wasp motor, which has carried me over the North Atlantic, part of the Pacific, to and from Mexico City, and many times across this continent. Aviation, this young modern giant, exemplifies the possible relationship of women and the creations of science. Although women as yet have not taken full advantage of its use and benefits, air travel is as available to them as to men.